Thank you. Sorry about the delay. I'm sure Billy Crystal never had to do that at the Academy Awards. Right. It's fancy dress time. And we have judges. And I'm going to introduce them to you one at a time. So will you please welcome up our first judge this evening, visual effects supremo, Mr. Mike Tucker. Secondly, the Supreme Commander, Jacqueline Pierce. Next, the man whose rebellion inspired us all, Gareth Thomas. He's at the bar, is he? Oh, what a surprise. Couldn't have guessed that one. Oh. Next up.
Just can't get the staff. Takes so long, gotta fight.
Blake's right-hand lady, Sally Navette. Penultimately, the gentleman who made it all possible, Mr. David Maloney. And finally, as I said earlier, the man you can all boo because he blew up the Liberator, Matt Irvin. Judges. Judges, do you understand what we have to do?
No.
Excellent. That makes all of us then. I will be bringing on one at a time some people who've made some rather fantastic fancy dress costumes. And you have to mark them individually as they come in, and at the end we'll announce some winners.
The people or the costumes?
The costumes.
How do we mark them
now? Marks out of 10. Right. That was a bit arbitrary, wasn't it? Marks out of 10. Yes, there's 15 of them.
15?
There's 15 of them. And so, without further ado, I'm going to bring on entrant number one. There has been...
Ah.
Can we put the main lights on? That's a very good point. What do we want to do? We're going to put the house lights up? Thank you. We're going to put the house lights up.
Have they made these?
Yes. Are they all made? We need these ones on. Yes?
Can I have a bar that works?
Yes.
There you are, sir.
Thank you, madam. That's what
I'm saying. Has anyone got a cigarette? Ah.
So who's made this?
15. That counts as one. This counts as one.
What number are you?
No. Just one overall thing. Yes, but it counts as group number one. So you're judging on this group en masse. Yes. Right, as you can tell, we know what we're doing. So, back to the story at hand, they said. There has been speculation as to what went on aboard Liberator after dark. Was Avon having an affair with Callie? Or was Blake? There was no sex on the Liberator. None at all. Absolutely, definitely, no sex at all. Ladies and gentlemen, Blake, Callie and Avon, Judith Proctor, Mary O'Connor and Catherine Anderson. Please mark this down as number three. There is no number two. We start as we mean to go on up here, you know. Yeah, I've never seen. Yes, number three. There is no number two. Seriously. Because I've got to introduce him as three. Okay? Are we sorted? Number three. Ladies and gentlemen, I give you the only Decima who has experienced time travel. This costume was made by Richard Proctor and is being worn by Henry Proctor. Fisher's little fella. I hope that when it's time to marvellous little fella. Wonderful. Not vicious at all. Number four. Six. We have Kevin Dawson as Avon with Moloch.
Remodeled your public image by separating your bad bits from the good. And which are you? Well, I suppose you look a bit more attractive now. Come on, let's go find Tony. He could always get a job in the Millennium Dome as an exhibit.
That was Kevin Dawson as Avon with Moloch. Number seven. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome back from her universal tour, the Supreme Empress herself, Servalan.
Get right to the point. I don't pop my cork for
ladies and gentlemen, David Walsh.
Need to locate a Mr. Dwellings in the main hall.
Ladies and gentlemen, I just need a quick interruption. Is there a Mr. and Mrs. Wellings in the main hall? Your baby is crying. It's all the message I've got. Okay. Moving straight on. Number 8. Here we have Kevin Hiley from Halifax as Keela from Gold. And the costume was made by Lisa, his sister. And now number 9, keeping it in the family, here is Lisa Hiley as the entity from Sarcophagus. And now number 10, a double act. We have Andrew Crimes and John Isles, editors of Stone Circle, all the way from Huddersfield, as the Orbit duo, Egrorian and Pinder. Number 11. Here we have Avon in his silver ensemble. Asher is 8 years old and a great fan of Avon's, and he's going to be back shortly in his second costume. Meanwhile, still as part of number 11, here we have Jared, who is 13 years old. Still number 11.
Still number 11.
No, this is number 11.
It could be 11A.
If you want it to be 11A, by all means make it 11A. Jared is 13 years old. And like Villa, he's a bit of a magician. Mr. Irvin, would you help the gentleman, please? Jared, by the way, is Asher's elder brother, and like Villa and Avon, they are constantly insulting each other. And here comes Asher again in his second costume. And note the mock snakeskin trousers. The costumes, by the way, were made by Mum. The props, however, were made by Asher and Jared themselves. Moving on now to number 12. This is Robert Puddy
as Babe and the Berserker. And joining him is Silvana Puddy as Servalan. Moving on now to number 13. Picture the scene. It's episode 26. The Andromedans are invading. A space commander attempts to inspire his troops to fight alongside the rebels. So, with apologies in advance to both William Shakespeare and Gareth Thomas, it might have sounded something like this. Jim Ward as a space commander in an outfit he made himself. Davros's latest attempt to take over the universe has led him to develop a way to tap into youth culture. This has resulted in the following mutation. Davros Enterprises, TM, are proud to present Carlig Spice. Number 15. Someone's got a noisy camera. Shall we wait for you? Thank you. There's a bit of ritual humiliation for you. Number 15. The Clone Masters. The Federation is in tatters. Mankind's influence in the galaxy is at an all-time low. And out of the chaos come new clone masters, reborn to return mankind to greatness. They have studied the fragmented remains of the histories, found the DNA banks of their illustrious forebears, struggled to relearn the secrets of the clone masters of old, and rebuilt the technology that enabled mankind to rule supreme. At last, their efforts bear fruit. They have succeeded in producing a pair of clones that they believe will return mankind to greatness. Ladies and gentlemen, the Clone Masters are proud to present Travis and Servalan, the younger, heroes for a new generation. Well, better luck next time. But they deserve something for effort, don't they? The costume, props and makeup was by Paul Holroyd with assistance from Kathy. And finally we come to number 16. On a similar theme, the Clone Masters have achieved their aim. A clone of Servalan is once more Supreme Empress. The skill of the Clone Masters is legendary. We've seen their handiwork this evening. However, Servalan has a final request of the Clone Masters. One thing needed to make her triumph complete. Ladies and gentlemen, that brings our exhibitionists to an end. Our judges will now retire to the bar to consider their verdict. Look at that smile on Gareth's face. And we will have an answer for you very, very shortly. We're going to, can we have a top three when you've finished deciding?
Whose top's going to be free?
Cheap. Cheap, David. Very cheap.
Okay. Give me Blake's up. It goes with the series.
Oh. Oh, I'm being spoken to.
All right, well, when you do, when you sort that out with them in the bar, they're going to come out.
Come.
Would you please note, it was not me that said we're going to the bar.
But I know how to get on the right side of this man. I thought he was going to take the second one down then as well. Go on, Gareth. Go on!
I will not tonight, nor will I attempt to, but if it were not fizzy, I might. I once did an advert for beer.
Really? Ladies and gentlemen, while our judges get into deep thought, consider strongly and all that, and go back to the bar, we're going to have a short sort of five minute break before we come back with the results of that, and then it'll be the cabaret. So if anyone wants to run to the bar themselves and top themselves up, please do so, and we'll be back in about 5 minutes. Two of the most beautiful judges in the world, and Gareth.
Thank you very much. Right, so, big moment. And I think we're going to start with the category for the kids, children's category. And very hard decision, because they were all absolutely terrific. But in the end, the clear winner was number three, the Decima.
That's Henry Proctor.
Henry Proctor. Well done. Well done.
Hooray. And in the best Servalan category. Gosh, it was difficult. I had David Maloney just now saying, I wish I cast him. I took his point. And the winner is, surprise, surprise, number 7.
David Walsh.
David. You're better than me.
Well, my turn.
No, we don't. No. Go away again now. Right. We don't want to see you anymore. Take it off. Yeah. The prize is... I'll explain that afterwards. Go ahead.
He's going to explain after. Do I need this?
Yeah. Yes.
No. And the prize for the best Blake 7 is... No, it's not. Is number 15.
The Clone Masters, Sue Cowley, Kathy Holroyd, and Sarah Brennan. All our winners will
receive... Have you seen their backs? Turn on...
The prizes will be awarded tomorrow in the closing ceremony, so there are prizes, and that will be done tomorrow afternoon.
Great. Okay. Thank you all very, very much indeed.
Talented people.
An extremely
people
high standard, and it does actually sometimes humble us to see people doing us better than we did it.
Thank you very much. And thank you to our judges. Those of you wondering about something that appears to be called, and I'm bound to have got this wrong, Love or Lust in the Liberator. Was it Love or Lust in the Liberator? Was that right? Well, yes, obviously. It's one of the fan panels. That's going to move back to 10 o'clock this evening because we're about to go into the cabaret. Let me do that again. Because we're about to go into the cabaret. And... Are we ready to go, boys and girls? Yes, I'll take that silence as a yes. First up tonight, will you give a very warm welcome to somebody you've already met quite recently this evening. A very, very warm welcome for Mr. David Walsh. We'll be right back. Can I drag you in? You're on. Whew. What a star that man is. What a star. I'm going to do it from down here. I'm not walking up there. So, but that's my best side. First I was afraid, I was petrified. Kept thinking I could never live without you by my side. But then I spent so many nights thinking how you did me wrong. And I grew strong. And I learned. And his mother always said he was such a quiet, studious little boy.
Make you look mad. Yeah.